perhaps Radiohead made a mistake by giving credit. I'm no expert at this. I can't tell if they plagiarized the song by Albert Hammond and Mike Hazelwood. I found one post on a YouTube video for Hammond's version, not the Hollies. I'm trying to pinpoint where this person says it's identical.
If I could make a wish, I think I'd pass. Think of anything I need.
I'm making this video because there are a few comments left by AA. He is basically sticking up for Led Zeppelin and Radiohead. It might have been a fluke that Radiohead sounded exactly like the Hollies song or the other one, the original by Hammond and Hazelwood, performed by Hammond. Perhaps Radiohead figured, let's pay this off and forget about it. And then it just took off because Prince got involved, then Lana Del Rey brought this back. I don't think Sexy Sadie and Karma Police sound that similar, maybe a little bit. I need exact proof for plagiarism. Radiohead admitted to the crime. Maybe they should have kept denying it. Things will sound similar after a while. There's just so much medium to go around. I don't completely agree with UG Krishnamurti on that. There's nothing new, that none of us create anything. Any idea we have was planted. It arrived through us from outside sources. I don't agree with that. The thing is, one can easily prove something like My Sweet Lord by George Harrison was lifted from He's So Fine by the Chiffons. AA left a link to My Sweet Lord. That's precisely what I'm not looking for. That's not helpful. That feels like gaslighting. Why is that person doing this to me? The last video, I think that chord progression might have been stolen by Radiohead. I'm not trying to back them up completely. It's mysterious. I'm no expert at this to put it together. But here is George Harrison lifting from the Chiffons. I mean, he lifted the whole frickin' thing. Maybe this goes on more than we think. There's no debating Led Zeppelin. It's been known for a long time. UG Krishnamurti was onto something, but he didn't invent that idea of non-thinking. He was cynical, he ended up grumpy. That's not the way to go. So in conclusion, George Harrison obviously stole from the Chiffons. I don't know how he could have done that subconsciously. Maybe Radiohead, I don't know what's up with them. They did admit to it in that one case. And that's about it. It's an interesting topic. I'm willing to give my opinion. I think there are a lot of fake posts out there trying to diminish or confuse us. There seems to be no reason to read comments anymore. I am looking for weaponized autism. Let's find truth and entertainment, the real stuff.